Boot Boy Digger, Boot Black, Toronto 2010. Huh?
And what was your previous title?
I was a Black Mr. Black Eagle, Boot Black 2010.
Cool. So I guess first question is, how'd you get into boot blacking?
In the Canadian Armed Forces. I spent 3 years in the Army doing infantry and vehicle mechanics and doing a lot of boots, so I learned from the best, and my mentors and predecessors in MLT, Boot Black, have been giving me lots of instructive advice for the more technical competition end of it.
Right. So what do you have to do for technical? Do you have to, I guess you have to show your skill, right?
Yeah, you have to, each of the judges brought a pair of the boots for each contestant, and we had the three judges and the tally master. We all did a set of their boots. And then there was a question interview portion, and the speech last night at the MLT contest.
So you've got big boots to fill with McGee. I mean, how are you going to do that?
I do have big boots to fill, and lots of boots, because he owns lots of boots. Yeah, he's done amazing things, done lots of fundraising, done extensive travel. I only hope that I can live up to that standard in my title year.
Now, if I dumped you in the IML vendor market with three pieces of equipment and told you you had to do boots the next 8 hours, what would you have with you?
Like boot blacking equipment?
Yep. Only three pieces, that's it.
I'd need a kiwi cloth, some kiwi polish, and a couple of brushes, I guess.
All right, that sounds good. Cool. Boot blacking is like a big mystery for a lot of people. I mean, can the ordinary person just do boot blacking on their own boots?
Yes, it's one of the titles that you can actually learn and practice at and become quite adept at. It's like anything, you know, the more with practice you get better, and everybody likes a nice shiny pair of boots.
Yeah.
So we encourage more people to come out with interests in boot blacking, because there'll be a comp. There's always next year.
So if you're walking through and you look at boots when you're walking through a crowd probably. What's the pair of boots that will turn your head every time?
I think a set of Daners is pretty hot. Wesco's are nice.
Yep.
Just generally a well cared for pair of boots looks good on anybody.
Can you tell a lot about a guy by the way he takes care of his boots?
I think so. I think it has... It's a good indicator of how they live their life and sort of think of themselves. So like a dirty, scratched up pair of boots, unless they're marks of honor or something like that. I think if you take care of your boots, you take care of your life and take care of your friends and family. And
cool.
It's kind of all a package.
So do you black at the Eagle on a regular basis?
I do. I'm going to start, Sundays is going to be my regular sort of day during the barbecue. So I'm going to try to be a little more regular doing that. Sunday nights, make that my day.
Cool.
Sort of thing.
And what are you going to get ready to do for the competition IML?
Polish boots.
Practice.
Practice lots of boots and just keep doing what I've been doing and raising money and picking a charity for our three title holders. I have to come up with a charity between us to give all of our money to, and
awesome.
So I think it's going to be very busy. Lots of leather spearhead events, which apparently I have to attend most of or all of.
Probably.
So it's going to be a busy but hopefully productive year.
All right. So advice for somebody who wants to become a boot black and or go into competition for boot black.
Come out to a workshop or come to a seminar or just come and tap me on the shoulder while I'm blacking at the Eagle.
Cool.
And we'd be more than happy to bring some new people into our fold.